गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? ओके, वी हैव डन विद हैलोजन एल्केन्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट अ न्यू चैप्टर, अल्कोहल्स, फिनॉल्स एंड ईथर्स. ओके, सो फर्स्ट लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट अल्कोहल. सो व्हाट इज अल्कोहल? You have seen alcohol, meaning in beverages, you know that alcohol is there, right? So just like, let us go in detail about the chemistry of alcohols today, okay? So alcohol is actually written like this, okay? This is alcohol. So how this alcohol we are getting, you know the corresponding alkyne, right? CH4. In CH4, one or two of the hydrogen atom is replaced by an OH group, you will get what? You will get an alcohol. Understand? When it is replacing, you will get an alcohol like this. Clear? So this is the formation of alcohol. Okay. Now, you don't want to learn much about the classification, but this classification is very important. So that is why only this classification at least you have to know. Okay. So what are the, this is alcohol is classified as primary, secondary and a tertiary alcohol. Okay. So primary means either you can learn in this way, the alcohol containing carbon atom is having two hydrogen atom, then it is primary. Or you can learn in this way, if the alcohol bearing carbon atom is attached with only one alkyl group, then it is called a primary alcohol. If it is the alcohol carrying carbon atom is attached with a two alkyl group, then it is called a secondary alcohol. Okay. If the OH bearing carbon is attached with a three alkyl group, then it is called a tertiary. This is the classification. Okay. Here. Yeah. So let us see the nomenclature of alcohols. Okay, let us see that now. So I will discuss a few rules how we will name it. Okay, the first rule is find the longest chain including OH group. Suppose this is, I will give you an example and I will explain this, then it will be easy for you. Okay, so this is an alcohol. So find the longest chain including OH group. So this is the, here this is the longest chain including the OH group. Okay. Now number the carbon atom in such a way that the carbon bearing OH must contain the lowest number. So you can number in two different way. 1, 2, 3, 4 in this way, or 1, 2, 3, 4 in this way. So which numbering is correct? The first numbering is correct because the carbon bearing OH is getting the lowest number in this way. Okay. So the numbering, this numbering is wrong. Actually this numbering is correct. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now name the branch first. Suppose you have a branch here also. Okay. You have a branch here also. So you have to name the branch first. So what is the name of the branch? This branch. What is the name of the branch? Only one carbon in the branch. So it is methyl, right? Methyl. And which position is the methyl group? Third position. So you have to name the branch in this way. 3-methyl followed by the alcohol. Now you have to name the alcohol. How? Alkan position all. Okay. So you have to count the number of carbon atom. 1, 2 in the longest chain. This is our longest chain, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbon atom means it will be butane. In this pattern we are writing. Alkan means butane. And which position is the OH group? Second position. So 2. All. This is the name. Understand? 3-methyl-butan-2-all. This is the IUPAC name. We are learning IUPAC naming. Okay. Now, if more than one OH group is present, suppose another case we can see CH3, CHOH, CHOH, CH3. In this case, what we have to do, the same thing we are doing, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you are numbering from this side also, you will get the same thing, 2, 3, the number you will get for OH group. So we are numbering in this way. And after that, we don't have any branch here. So we are naming it as alkan. Alkan is not writing. If there is more than one OH, you can write alkane itself. So four carbon atom. So it is butane. And which position is the OH group? Second position and third position. So 2, 3. Put a hyphen. And how many OH is there? 2. So if 2 is there, we will write diol. If 3 is there, triol. So this is diol. Okay, so what is the name? Butane, 2, 3, diol. Understand? This is the naming. This is the rule to name the alcohols. Okay. Now let us see some of the example. This is already in your textbook, but I will explain you how to name it. Okay. So here CH3OH, one carbon atom. So this is common name. IUPAC name is more important. You have to learn this. Okay. How to name it. There is a procedure for that. So CH3OH, only one carbon atom. So methanol. Look at this. This is the first position is the OH group. Three carbon atoms. So propan, one all. Okay. And here second position, same propan, but second position. So propan, two all. Now look this, 1, 2, 3, 4. So butane, first position is the all. So one all. Alkan, position all. So here the same number of carbon atoms, but second position is butane, two all. Here, the same number of carbon atom is there, but one is branch. So, the longest chain consists of only three carbon atom, right? So, it is first position is the OH group, second position methyl. So, 2 methyl, propan, 1 all. Okay, here, the longest chain is this one. Which is the longest chain here? This is the longest chain. So, we will number 1, 2, 3, and second position branch, second position OH group. So, 2 methyl, propan, 2 all. Okay. And here 2 OH group is there. So ethylene glycol is a common name. Otherwise, ethane, E we will write here. For substance, second position we have all. So 1, 2 are there, diol. Okay. So here 3 OH groups are there. So propane, 1, 2, 3, triol. In this way, we will name it. Okay. Now, if cycloalkanes upon that OH group is present, how we will name it. Okay. Cyclic alcohol are named using the prefix cyclo in front of the name. So here, look at this example. Here you can see this is how many carbon atom in this. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So it is hexane, one all. We are not writing one because all the places are equivalent. Only one OH is there. So wherever OH is placed, it will be one all. So no need to write it. It is understood already. So hexane, one all actually. So we can write it as hexanol, but it is cyclic so that we will write cyclo in front of that. And here there is a branch also. So we should name the branch first. Second position, 2 methyl. And this entire thing is cyclo. And how many carbon atoms are there? We will number it like starting from here, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon atoms. So pentanol, pentan, one all. If you write, that is also correct. Okay. So that's all for the naming. Okay. Now let us see the preparation of alcohol. How can we prepare alcohol? Different method of preparation. We can prepare alcohol from alkene. Simply, we have learned the reactions of alkene. I think you have learned this in grade 11. Okay. When you react alkene with water, actually water in this form of steam we are using, and in the presence of an acid catalyst, we are using an acid catalyst like phosphoric acid. What will happen here? Look at the CH2 double bond CH2. Water we can write as HOH. So this bond will break. One of the H will join here. One of the OH will join here. So we will get CH3CH2OH. Okay. This is the case of symmetric alkene. for example, CH2 double bond CH2, if you take both the sides, same groups are present. So it is called a symmetric alkene. So symmetric alkene, wherever you want, you can shift the hydrogen and OH and we will get the product. Okay. But if it is an unsymmetrical alkene, the case of an unsymmetrical alkene is like the CH3, CH double bond, CH2. So if you cut along the double bond, here different group. So this is called an unsymmetrical alkene. So if you are taking an unsymmetrical alkene, CH3, CH double bond, CH2, and if the same reaction, H2O gas in the presence of acid catalyst, the same reaction is taking place, HOH is there. So here, the major product we are finding using Markovnikov's rule. In Markovnikov's rules, always hydrogen will go to the place where there is more hydrogen atom. Okay. So not on this CH3, on the double bond carbon atom, where is more hydrogen atom, there this hydrogen will go and OH will go to the place where there is least number of hydrogen. So we will get a product CH3, CHOH, CH3. This is the major product and we will get minor product also, CH3, CH2, CH2OH. We are going to get two products, but it is in accordance with the Markovnikov's rule. Okay. So what we are doing, acid catalyzed hydration. Hydration means addition of water. Acid catalyzed, any acid like a concentrated sulfuric acid or phosphoric acid, H3PO4, we can use here. Okay. Now, let us see the next case. Now, hydroboration oxidation is the another reaction. Hydroboration oxidation, what we are using the reagent is diborane, CH3 twice or BH3 twice or B2H6 is the reagent we are using here. Okay. And we will get, this is oxidized to alcohol by hydrogen. We are using hydrogen peroxide to undergo oxidation in the presence of sodium hydroxide. Okay, so let us see this reaction. In this particular reaction, look at this reaction. In this reaction, what is happening? This BH2 and H bond is there, right? This hydrogen will be moving to the place where there is least number of hydrogen and BH2 part will be moving to the place where there is most number of hydrogen in the double bond. So look at this, the first product you can see CH3, after that CH2, because hydrogen is going to, it is opposite of Markovnikov's rule is happening. It looks like opposite of Markovnikov's rule and BH2 will come here. Okay. Again, this CH3, CH double bond, CH2 will react. And the same case to be, case will happen here. This BH2, we can write as BHS. So this H will be going here and this part entirely will come here. Okay, so what will happen? CH3, CH2, CH2, okay. And we will get BH here and the other side you will get CH3, CH2, CH2, right? So both together is written here. That's why, don't confuse. Both together, that is this group and this group together. This is actually CH2, CH2, CH3. These two, both group together is written here. That is why CH3, CH2, CH2 twice BH is written. And again, among this BH, what will happen? H will be, again, it is going to react with this. So H will be going and attaching here and the entire thing, this entire thing will be attaching on this one. So we will get CH3, CH2, CH2 thrice B, okay? And now it is undergoing oxidation in the presence of, we are using H2O2 and in the presence of an alkali, the entire thing will be converting into OH will add up here. So three molecules are there. We'll get three molecule of propanol along with the, this also will convert into BOH thrice. Okay. So this is the reaction here also. We are going to more yield we are getting here. Okay. Yes. Now, let us see the next case. from carbonyl. The second case is the preparation from carbonyl compounds. Okay, so how we will get? We can have different methods. Okay, so the first method is by reduction of aldehyde and ketones. Okay, aldehyde and ketones are reduced to the corresponding alcohol by addition of a hydrogen in the presence of catalyst. So that is called a catalytic hydrogenation. We are going to undergo catalytic hydrogenation. We already know that in grade 11, we have learned catalytic hydrogenation. What we are using hydrogen, catalytic hydrogenation means hydrogen in the presence of platinum or palladium catalyst. This is catalytic hydrogenation. If you do that, you will get the corresponding alcohol. So that is written here, catalyst is a finely divided metal such as platinum and a palladium, or nickel also you can use. Or another method is there by treating aldehyde and ketone with a sodium borohydrate, or you can undergo reduction using sodium boron hydride or lithium aluminium hydride. Okay, but lithium aluminium hydride we are not usually using because it is very expensive. So very precious compounds preparation, we are usually using lithium aluminium hydride. It is possible, but another method is also possible. So chemistry always go for economic, means less expense should be there. Okay, aldehyde yield primary alcohol, whereas ketone gives secondary alcohol. Let us see. So these are the product we are getting. So let us see that. So look at this reaction. We can undergo two types of, this is catalytic hydrogenation. Okay. So you have to understand each place hydrogen will be adding up. Okay. Here one H, here one H. So what will happen? RCH2OH. This is catalytic hydrogenation. Hydrogen in the presence of palladium, platinum or nickel, this will convert into RCH2OH. Here also the same thing. H will be added up here, and H will be added up here. So what will happen? RCHOH R dash will be the product. So this is actually primary alcohol. We will get primary alcohol by treating with a platinum or a nickel by hydrogenation of a which one alcohol? Sorry, aldehyde. Aldehyde will be giving you the primary alcohol. And if you are using a ketone, ketone will give you a secondary alcohol. This you have to understand. In order to get a primary alcohol, we have to use aldehyde. In order to get secondary alcohol, we have to use a ketone. Both will undergo reduction either by catalytic hydrogenation or using sodium boron hydride or lithium aluminium hydride. Clear? So now next, another method is there by reduction of carboxylic acid and esters. Okay, so ketone and aldehyde so far we learned. Now carboxylic acid are reduced to primary alcohol by lithium aluminium hydride. Again, we are using here lithium aluminium hydride. It is a strong reducing agent. Let us see the reaction. So lithium aluminium hydride followed by hydrolysis. If you are doing, you will get, you know, the corresponding alcohol, primary alcohol. RCOOH is converting into RCH2OH. Okay, addition of hydrogen take place. So this is reduction reaction. Okay, lithium, so I already discussed lithium aluminium hydride is an expensive reagent. So we are only preparing using this for the preparation of a very special compounds. Okay, so if another methods are possible, we will follow that method because lithium aluminium hydride is very expensive. Okay, so what we are doing is acids first reduced to alcohol by converting them to esters. First it is converting them to esters and followed by the reduction using hydrogen in the presence of a catalyst, we will get an alcohol. Let us see that reaction. So look here, our first reaction is esterification. First, we have to convert an acid into, that is what we discussed now. An acid is first converting into an ester. So the first reaction is called a esterification reaction. So RCO double bond OOH is reacting with an alcohol ROH. So H2O will eliminate here and then what will happen? It will be converting into RC double bond O R dash. So that is what happening here. This is called an esterification reaction that will take place only in the presence of an acid. Okay. So after that, you reduce it using hydrogen in the presence of nickel or platinum. This is a simple method, less expensive method, and this will be, this already we seen that it can convert into the corresponding primary alcohol, RCH2OH and R dash OH we are going to get. So two alcohol we are going to get are RCH2OH here, RCH2OH we are getting, and also we are getting ROH, two alcohol we are going to get. Okay, so this will give a better yield of alcohol. Now we have another method that is from Grignard reagent. Okay, how we will get from Grignard reagent? Let us see. Alcohol are produced by the reaction of Grignard reagent with the aldehyde. Okay, so how the reaction is going? So this is an aldehyde. C double bond group is there, and you have RMGX. We know that it is having negative charge. This is plus, and this is also minus, right? So what is happening here? This bond is actually breaking, and it is negative. Okay, it will be shifting to here, so that it will get a negative charge and it will get a positive charge. Since it is positive, what will happen? The negative part is R minus, that will be shifting to this positive part, and this entire part will be shifting to this negative part, MgX. Okay, so you will get the product ROMGX adduct. This is an intermediate. And after that, it will undergo hydrolysis. When it undergo hydrolysis, how it will undergo? Here it will add H and here it will add OH. So you will get an alcohol follow and MgOHX, two product. This is the main mechanism for the reaction of Grignard reagent. Okay. So now let us see each and every reactions here. So HCHO is reacting here, right? So HCHO means what? HC double bond O H. This is HCHO. When it is reacting with the RMGX, what is happening? This is minus, this part is plus. So this is minus, this is plus, right? So here R is moving, here MGX is moving. So you will get CH2 R O M G X, you will get. Now it will undergo hydrolysis, H O H. So you will get R CH2 O H plus M G O H X. This is happening here. In this case, R CH2 is reacting with the, so the same reaction is happening here also. R C O R is reacting with the R M G X. R C double bond O R is reacting with RMGX. Same here minus, here plus, here minus, here plus. So R will come here, right? R will be coming here. This R dash will be coming to this place and MGX will be coming to this place. This becomes single bond. And whenever it undergo hydrolysis, here you will, sorry, here you will get H and here you will get OH. So R C, you will get this product that is tertiary alcohol along with the MgOHX you will be getting. This is the reaction with the Grignard reagent. Okay. Now, let us discuss physical and chemical properties in next lesson. So that's all for today. Bye.